His daddy was known to be a mean gunslinger. His mama was a dance hall queen. His brothers got together and robbed Wells Fargo before Billy turned 13. They were bad blood.
Bad blood.
Bad blood.
Bad blood.
Everybody said they had bad blood.
Bad blood.
On his 16th birthday, Bill left home, never to return again. He ran to get away from the shame that would haunt him to the end. He could never wear a family name or hold his head up high. His brothers stole, he robbed and killed. That's the reason why they said he had bad blood.
Bad blood.
Bad blood.
Bad blood.
Everybody said he had bad blood.
Bad blood.
He finally got a job at a country store. The bank was down the street. 2 days later, the bank was robbed, so they made him leave. He drifted on from town to town, but no matter how he tried. Wanted posters were everywhere, there was just no place to hide. They said he had bad blood.
Bad blood.
Bad blood.
Bad blood.
Everybody said he had bad blood.
Bad blood.
Then one day in a little place known as Sundown, a big black stud full of local weed came charging through the town. Bill turned the stud, but flashing hoofs cut Billy swift and deep. Still he tried to hold on even as his blood ran into the dusty street. When Billy lost his grip, the stallion threw him to the wall. Blood stains remain there to this day, so the town folks still recall. The kid who saved the baby's life so many years ago. They don't speak of him as bad blood now, but poor Billy doesn't know. They said he had bad blood.
Bad blood.
Bad blood.
Bad blood.
Everybody said he had bad blood.